नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्यासंप्रदायकर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपपन्नैः प्रज्ञानकर्तृ ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च स्थामकं च शिष्यं तन्तूटकं वार्तिककारमन्यमस्मद्गुरून् सन्तु श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयङ्कृणालयं भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदं भागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूचनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितं नमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽपि यरो हरिसहोदरापमहत्पदम् तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकशाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतम् So the tika, we saw the shankha by the or the discussion between Vachaspati Mishra followers, Bhamati followers, and Vivarana followers. So Mishra Mata Anusarina Hastu. There we saw as to there cannot be a vidhi in jnana and in Ichha also. So there was a discussion, but then this is also the topic where Purvapakshi is objecting. So that is taken up as Nanu Kartavyattvam. Here you have said in the Ratnaprabha Vyakhyana what has been said. Kartavya Pada should be added to Athatu Brahma Jidnyasa Sutra. Thereby you will get Ekavakyata between the Shrotavya Mantra, Vidhi Mantra and the first Sutra. So nanu kartavyattvam, kim kartavyattvam nama? So what is this kartavyattvam? When you say kartavya, brahma jidnyasa kartavya, then what is the meaning of kartavya there? Kartavyattvam kim? So nanu kartavyattvam kriti sadhyattvam. That which is possible with kriti, kriti is yatna. So yatna sadhyattvam kartavyattvam. So it is Kartrutantra. Tathacha jnana ichyo krutya sadhyatvena. Jnana and ichha, however, are kruti asadhya. They are yatna asadhya. You cannot have jnana, you cannot make yatna in jnana. To get jnana is one thing, but for jnana itself, meaning the, yesterday we saw as an example, to look at green as red. You cannot cognize one thing differently with effort. Yatna is not possible in that case. It is not going to yield any results. So, kritya sadhyatvena, jnana ichyayo kritya sadhyatvena, kartavyatvasya ananvayat. Then, brahma jidnyasa kartavya, you will have to break it. Brahma jidnyasa kartavya means what? Jidnyasa kartavya. Jidnyasa kartavya may sound right, because it is Trilinga Shabda. Beyond that, there is no meaning to it. If you say Brahmanaha Jidnyasa Kartavya, meaning what? Brahmanaha Jnyatum Ichha Kartavya. So Jnyatum is the Jnyadhatu meaning. And San Pratyah has been added, which is Ichharte San. Therefore, Jnyatum Ichha Kartavya. So Jnyatum Kartavya or Ichha Kartavya. In Ichha also, you cannot have Kartavyattva vidhi, meaning you cannot have kriti sadhyattva. It is, Ichha is not kriti sadhya, yatna sadhya, and jnana is also not yatna sadhya. Thereby, what exactly is the anvaya here? There is no anvaya possible here. So what has to be done in this case? Thereby, kartavyatvasya ananvayat. Kartavya padam katham adhyartavyam. Why do you say kartavyatva pada has to be added? Shruti rupa moola pramana rahitatvena idam sutram apramanam. Thereby, what is the conclusion now? Kartavyatva has absolutely no anvaya possible in the, even if you add it. Brahma jijnyasa, athato brahma jijnyasa. Kartavya, once you add it, then anvaya is not possible. Then why do you add a word which has no anvaya? In fact, you add a word only when anvaya is not clear. Then you bring in a word and add. Now you have added a word which does not make any sense. There is no anvaya. Thereby, what has happened now? What you are trying to do is what? You are making it to give the same meaning as Shrotavya mantra. However, anvaya is failing. Thereby, what has happened? Ataha shruti rupa moola pramana rahitatvena. Now this has no connection with the Shrotavya vidhi, because kartavya pada is kartavya iti pada. That pada has absolutely no connection to jnana also, icha also. Therefore, kartavyatvam is invalidated. Once it is invalidated, then it has fallen apart from the Shrotavya vidhi, where ekavakyata was being mentioned. Ekartattvam, ekavakyata is ekartattvam. Ekartha between the sutra and the Shrotavya mantra is no longer there. Once it is not there, what has happened? Shruti rupa moola pramana rahitatvena. There is no pramana for your sutra anymore. Shruti is no longer pramana. Therefore, what? Idam sutram apramanam. This sutra is apramana. And thereby what? Narambhaniyam shastram. That is the final goal of the Purva Pakshi. Iti ashankam sangrahena udghatya pariharati. So what the Ratna Prabhakara is doing, he is raising this doubt. Bhagavan Ramananda Yati is raising this doubt briefly and then giving a parihara to this. Tatreti vyakhya. Tatra prakriti pratyarthayor jnanechayoho kartavyatva ananvayat prakritya phalibhutam jnanam ajal lakshanaya uchyate. So what he is saying is, you are right that kartavya does not have an anvaya directly, but sutras are not that simple. Sutra has to be understood in sampradaya, and the complete sense will be there only when you don't do your independent analysis. You raise these doubts to your acharya, and then that is cleared in the sampradaya itself, the way it was cleared earlier. So what Bhagavan Vyasacharya has taught, that meaning will be clear only when you follow the sampradaya. Otherwise, doubts will be pending, and then you'll say, oh, apramadam. Even if you have shraddha in the shastra, the shraddha in the sutras will go away, sutrakara will go away. So you shouldn't do that. What is he saying? Understand how this sutra is to be analyzed. So kartavya does not have an anvaya directly, but you have to do lakshana. When the anvaya is not possible, shakyartha is not possible, what do? You do lakshana. So lakshana has to be done. Prakriti pratyarthayor jnana ichyo. Prakriti is what? Jnana. Jnatum ichha jijnyasa there. Prakriti is jnadhatu. So jnana is the meaning there. And then pratya is san pratya. Ichharte san. Therefore, ichha is the meaning. Jnana ichyoho kartavyatva ananvayat. You are right. There is no anvaya there directly, even after adding kartavya. But kartavya has been added because it is a vidhi, and the shravana vidhi, shrotavya, is being analyzed here. There will always be ek vakya between the sutra and the mantra which is being analyzed. Ek artha will be there. Thereby, kartavyatva has been added. Kartavya. But lakshana has to be done even then. We have not finished it. It has been added, but I'll tell you what is the lakshana there. Prakritya phalibhutam jnanam. You have to take by prakriti. Prakriti is what? Jnana. So jnana itself, in jnana there cannot be any kartavyatva vidhi. But therefore what you should do is, you should take the meaning of the jnana as phalibhuta jnana. Dukkha nivritti rupa jnana should be taken there. Meaning phalibhutam jnana means jnana phala has to be taken. Anyway, we'll come back to this because this is just mentioned here. There is an objection here also. So, phalibhutam jnanam. How do you take that? Ajah lakshanaya. It is still jnana, but it is phalibhuta jnana. Therefore, without giving up jnana, you are taking up an additional meaning. That is with ajah lakshana. So, I'll not go there. You know this as to the Shvetodhavati. That is an example there. Tika. Tatreti. Sutre adhyahare avashyakartavye satityata. Tatra is what? Tasmin. Saptamyarthe tral. So what is this? Tatra. Tatra prakriti pratyarthayur. So tatra means sutre adhyahare avashyakartavyatve sati. Avashyakartavye sati. So if you add kartavya, there is avashyakartavyatvam for the adhikari. So avashya kartavye sati, kim kartavye, this adhyahara, if you do that, sutre adhyare avashya kartavye sati, sati saptami tatra, what happens? There you say prakriti pratyaya have absolutely no connection to kartavya pada, anvaya is not possible. Why? So this nya dhatu, prakriti is what? Nya dhatu, nya avabodhane, iti dhatu hu prakriti, pratyaya san pratyaya iti viveka, ichharte san iti viveka. Iti vivekaha, phalibhutam iti. What is phalibhutam? Jnanam, ajalakshanaya. Ajnana nivritti rupa phalasadhanatvena phalibhutam ityartha. So that jnana, which has a visheshana. Phalibhutam means, phalibhuta, that visheshana is ajnana nivritti rupa phalasadhanatvena jnanam. So ajnana nivritti rupa phalasadhanibhuta yajnanam. Tajnanam. So you have added a visheshana. Rakto dhavati, raktaha ashva dhavati. So visheshana or vishesha. You have to add something which are in samanadikaranyam. Thereby the word which stands for the entity, that is not dropped. You keep the word and you add another which also stands for the entity. Samanadikaranyam is there. That is, it is still jnana. So it is ajal lakshana without dropping the word jnana, but it is phalibhutam jnanam. And what is the phala there? Ajnana nivritti rupa phala is there. And this jnana is sadhana tool. It's therefore sadhani bhuta jnanam. That is which is a sadhana for, so phalibhutam, but then still that which is what kind of phala? Ajnana nivritti rupa phala, which was already sadhana. So not sadhani bhuta per se, but it is that which is phalibhuta. So sadhana, it all, it was as sadhana, but then now you shift your meaning to the phala without dropping the sadhana. So that's the idea there. Ajnana nivritti rupa phala sadhanatvena phalibhutam ityartha. Phalibhutam kim? Phalibhutam jnanam. Jnavabodhane prakriti artha is jnana, which is the phala now. Ajahaditi. And what is ajah lakshana here? Vachyartasya jnanasya atyagad ajah lakshana iti bhavah. Since the vachyartha jnana has not been dropped, even after lakshana, the jnana word is retained, which is vachyartha. Therefore, this is ajal lakshana. Nanu tathapi ukta dosha tadavasthyam ityatah. So, savastha tadavastha. Tadavasthayaha bhava tadavasthyam. So, here there is an objection. Nanu tathapi ukta dosha. What is the ukta dosha? What is that I am pointing out, says the Purva Pakshi. I am pointing out there is no anvaya. You accept that there is no anvaya possible. Then you say from kartavya being added, I have taken phalibhuta jnana because with jnana there is no anvaya. Even after that there is no anvaya, sir. What kind of lakshana have you done? So he says, tathapi ukta dosha tadavasthyam iti दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्शन आई हैव मेड एंड दैट ऑब्जेक्शन इज स्टिल देयर. इश्वी से फलीभूतम ज्ञानम कर्तव्य वुडंट वर्क. हाउ डू से फलीभूतम ज्ञानम कर्तव्यम देन? नॉट पॉसिबल. देयर ऑल्सो द ऑब्जेक्शन स्टिल स्टैंड्स. वॉट अबाउट दैट? इत्यतः देयर द रिस्पॉन्स इज गिवन एज प्रत्ययेन इति. व्याख्या: प्रत्ययेन इच्छा साध्य विचार जह लक्षणया. Says wait, wait. Siddhanti says wait, don't jump the gun. I have still not finished my lakshana. Lakshana is not only in the, see, when this shakyartha does not make sense directly, then the implied meaning is by lakshana. Lakshana is on both parts of the world. It is also on the prakriti and the pratyaya. Prakriti jnana means phalibhuta jnana by ajal lakshana, whereas the pratyaya also has an implied meaning, not a direct meaning. And that lakshana is jahal lakshana. So, pratyena ichha sadhya vicharaha jahal lakshanaya. Jahal lakshana is by dropping that. Oha tyage. Jahati lakshana. Jahal lakshana. Like gangayam ghosha. So, you drop the word ganga, which means pravaha, and take the word, because on ganga pravaha, nadi, there cannot be a ghosha. So, you take the meaning which is the banks of the river. Thereby, Ganga Tira, Pravaha Tira is the meaning. You drop the meaning of Pravaha and take the meaning of Tira. So, Ganga Tire Ghoshaha, that is the meaning there. Therefore, you have dropped the main meaning and you have taken another meaning. Having dropped the Vachyartha of Gangayam, and taken Ganga Tire. So Tire is, the Tira is not Pravaha, therefore Jahal Lakshana. Similarly here you have to use that Pratyena Ichha Sadhya. You drop the Anvaya with the Ichha, Vachyartha you drop Ichha, but Vicharaha. Vichara Kartavya. Vicharaha Kartavya Natu Ichha Kartavya. This is how you will get a valid meaning. Pratyena Ichha Sadhya Vicharaha Jahal Lakshanaya. उच्यते तथा च ब्रह्मज्ञानाय विचारः कर्तव्यः इति सूत्रस्य श्रौतोर्थः संपद्यते. Thereby, what is the meaning now of the entire sutra? अथातो ब्रह्मजिज्ञासा will mean ब्रह्मज्ञानाय. ब्रह्मणः ज्ञानाय, ब्रह्मण फलीभूत ज्ञानाय विचारः कर्तव्यः. केन? अधिकारिणा. किमर्थं? मोक्ष प्राप्त्यर्थं. So, prapaka prapya sambandha is there. Praptir prapya sambandha we have already seen. So, sambandha is also there. Adhikari is included. Therefore, all four will be revealed by interpreting this sutra in such a manner. Iti sutrasya shrautahartha sampadyate. This is the meaning within the sutra. So, shrautahartha. Tika shakya sambandhini lakshana iti jnanartha. इति ज्ञानार्थम इच्छा साध्य पदम. सो शक्य संबंधिनी शक्तम पदम. द पद हैज शक्ति एंड व्हाट इज रिवील्ड बाय द पद शक्ति इज द अर्थ. देयर इज अ नित्य संबंध पद पदार्थयोः नित्य संबंध. सो शक्त एंड शक्य हैव नित्य संबंध. व्हेन दैट direct meaning does not make sense, there is some hidden meaning which can make sense. That is lakshana. That is also hidden in the word there. By having some shakti to reveal through lakshana also, it can reveal something. So shakya sambandhini, what is that? Through sambandha. Lakshana is what? Shakya sambandhini. It has to have connection with the with what is revealed by shakti. What yogyata should be there. The Sambandha should be with something which is yogya to be revealed by the Shakta Pada. Really, the Shakti hidden in the Pada, which is Ishvara Sanketa. In Sanskritam at least, Devanagari Bhasha. So, व्याकरण इज टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दी भाषा इज, इट इज नॉट टू क्रिएट न्यू वर्ड्स, टू अंडरस्टैंड साधु प्रयोग. सो वी अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दी वर्ड इज, दिस वर्ड हैज कम फ्रॉम, ऑल दीज वर्ड्स हैव कम फ्रॉम वेदास, दे हैव कम फ्रॉम ईश्वर. सो ईश्वर हैज एंडोर्ड द शब्द द पद विद द शक्ति टू रिवील द मीनिंग, अर्थ. सो शक्य संबंधिनी लक्षण इति ज्ञानार्थम इच्छा साध्य पदम, देयर बाय दिस इच्छा साध्य विचार इज क्लियरली नोन, इच्छा कर्तव्य, बट ज्ञानाय इच्छा कर्तव्य, देयरफॉर विचार इज क्लियरली हिडन देयर इन द मीनिंग एंड दैट इज द मीनिंग यू टेक देयर, देयर बाय वाच्यार्थ इच्छायाः परित्याग जह लक्षण इति भावः, सिंस यू हैव ड्रॉप्ड द वाच्यार्थ इच्छा एंड टेकन द इच्छा संबंध लक्षण विच इज विचार, देर फोर दिस इज जह लक्षण. श्रोत अर्थ व्यंग्यार्थात भिन्नो अर्थ लाक्षणिकार्थ इति यावत्. एंड व्हाट इज द श्रोत अर्थ फाइनली, द मीनिंग दैट वाज गिवन, दिस इज नॉट क्लियरली सीन व्हेन यू रीड ब्रह्म जिज्ञास कर्तव्य, इट साउंड्स राइट एंड देन यू मूव ऑन, फेयर इनफ, यू हैव श्रद्धा इनफ, बट इफ यू हैव स्टडीड व्याकरण एंड दैट इटसेल्फ बिकम्स अ स्टम्बलिंग ब्लॉक, you split the samasa, you split the samasa and then you see, oh, this does not make sense to me, because you have gone beyond the samasa and you have started looking at the dhatu also. There are some people with pratipadika, they say which is the dhatu, with pratipadika you should not be asking dhatu because you are dealing with subanta pada. If you start asking the dhatu there, then you have jumped the gun, you have not inquired into whether the word is a tadjita, whether it is a krudanta. Before inquiry to that, you have also dropped the vibhakti also. So you look at a noun, you forget the vibhakti and you start looking at the dhatu, means you have skipped multiple steps. Thereby what will happen? Anvaya will not make sense. So that is the case here, and thereby Mimamsa has to be like this so that you get the exact meaning of the sutra as to what should be the anuvritti and what should be the real interpretation of the sutra. And in sampradaya for athato brahma jijnyasa to have ekartha with shrotavya vidhi. So vyangyartha, which is directly seen, some meaning which is there, and this is not direct meaning. Whatever meaning you are seeing even after adding lakshana, that meaning is not the meaning. That is why you have objections. Because what is he saying? Vyangyarthad bhinna. Vyangyartha itself is some hidden meaning, implied meaning. It is not a direct meaning. And vyangyarthad bhinna means, from the meaning which is appearing to the Purva Pakshi after adding Lakshana on Prakriti, because he has not even heard that there has to be Lakshana on the Pratyaya also. So the meaning which is apparent after Lakshana on the Prakriti, Aja Lakshana, that is not the meaning. This meaning is after adding Lakshana on the Pratyaya also. Thereby what has happened? This Shrautartha, that is the product of these two lakshanas on Prakriti and Pratyaya respectively, Ajati and Jahati, that meaning is different. It is a Lakshanikartha iti yavata. Earlier was also Lakshanika, but it was a one step ahead. Before that, it was Vachyartha, which was not making any Anvaya. So Shrautartha, Vyangyarthad, Bhinnaha, Artha, लाक्षणिकार्थ इति यावत् सौत्रात शब्देन विशिष्टाधिकारी बोध्यते. सो नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग हियर? विशिष्टाधिकारी इज आल्सो नोन हियर. प्रयोजन एंड विषय इज देयर व्हिच इज बीइंग एनालाइज्ड, बट देन दिस प्रयोजन इज फॉर हूम? फॉर एन अधिकारी. देयर बाय वाच्यार्थ, देयर बाय सौत्र अथ शब्देन, दिस अथ शब्द व्हिच इज देयर, अथातो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा, अथ means Vishishtadhikari, who has finished sadhana chatushtaya sampatti thereafter. So artha means thereafter. After what? After the adhikari gains the sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. So sautra artha shabdena vishishta adhikari bodhyate. Not any adhikari, vishishta adhikari. Who is sadhana sampatti vishishta adhikari. तथा च साधन चतुष्टय संपन्नेन अधिकारिण. सो दिस इज अ विशिष्ट अधिकारी साधन संपत्ति विशिष्ट अधिकारी देयरफॉर ही साधन चतुष्टय संपन्न अधिकारी. सो साधन चतुष्टय संपन्नेन अधिकारिण ब्रह्म ज्ञानाय विचार कर्तव्य इति सूत्र वाक्यस्य श्रौता अर्थ. दिस इज द फाइनल मीनिंग. द एलिजिबल कैंडिडेट should inquire into, should do vichara. With what? With Shravana Vidhi tells you with which mantras. So the mantras alone, Vedanta Vakya eva vichara kartavya, vichara eva kartavya. For what? Moksha, nivritti rupa, jnana, phalibhuta, phalibhuta jnana, which is nivritti rupa, ajnana nivritti rupa. So Brahma jnana vichara kartavya iti sutra vakya se shravata artha. मोक्षेच्छायाः अधिकारी विशेषणत्वेन तद्वारा अधिकारी विशेषणीभूतः यः मोक्षः तत्साधनं ब्रह्मज्ञानं इत्यर्थात् सिद्ध्यति. नाउ देयर इज मोर इंप्लाइड मीनिंग. वंस दिस हैज बीन सेड देन व्हाट अबाउट द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द अनुबंध चतुष्टय. सो दीज आर ऑल इंप्लाइड मीनिंग्स. देयर इज सो मच इंप्लाइड देयर. इट इज नॉट अ सिंपल सूत्र. मोक्षेच्छायाः अधिकारी विशेषणत्वेन this ichha, whether it will be automatically there based on bhamati mata or whether there is a vidhi as to ichha sadhya vichara. Finally, the adhikari is known as to who should do vichara or who will end up doing vichara as per bhamati mata. So, we don't have any agraha there. After that, we don't have any agraha. Between Advaitins, there can be vada, but this is a samvada. We should not take it as a, you know, they may call names also because it gets a heated debate. But then we should not lose focus on the tatpare vishya, which is aikya in bhamati also and vivarana also. So there is no agraha on what should, you know, just because they are fighting, we should give up both. No, natyajyam. What should be done is, we can pick one. We can pick both also. No issues there. There are people who will tell you that, you know, because these two sampradayas are fighting, you take another sampradaya. It is not right. They are both sampradaya for us. Nonetheless, these are all, you know, this is vidvad manoranjana also. Those who have aikya siddhi, for them it is vidvad manoranjana. You know what is right. But then you enjoy the details. You enjoy the debate also in the details. So it looks right. Oh, he is also right. He is also right. And then you start taking, you know, sides. Just like in a game, you are enjoying a game. And in that game, you still have sides. You may feel bad also if your side does not win, but you have enjoyed the game. You enjoyed the game of the other. That other deserved the win. You don't give up on your side, but still you enjoy the play. This is the attitude of a sadhaka in Advaita sadhana. We should not extend it to everything else. Nonetheless, okay. So, what else is known in the sutra? Vishishta adhikari is known. Tathacha sadhana chatushte sampannena adhikarina. By this adhikari who has sadhana chatushte sampatti, what should he do? Tena vicharaha kartavya. What should be done by him? So to be very literal, vichara kartavya. For what purpose? Tadarthi chaturthi brahma jnana. Iti sutra vakyasi shrauta artha. Mokshechhayaha adhikari visheshanatvena tadvara. So adhikari visheshana is there for one who has mokshechha. Thereby tadvara, through that, what is that? Adhikari visheshani bhuta yaha mokshaha. Now this adhikari is a visheshana. Sadhana chatushte sampatti one adhikari. Therefore sadhana chatushte sampatti becomes a visheshana, vyavartaka for adhikari. There are adhikaris in yoga, there are adhikaris in lot of things. But this adhikari is what kind of an adhikari? he has a sadhana chatushte sampatti, he has sadhana chatushte sampatti, therefore that becomes a visheshana to the adhikari. Now this adhikari himself becomes a visheshana. Adhikari visheshani bhuta ya moksha, for moksha, because he is qualified for moksha. So this moksha is having a visheshana now. Who will get it? This adhikari. Which adhikari? He has a visheshana. Which visheshana? Sadhana chatushta sampatti. Thereby, all the way when you go, moksha is also what? Prapya rupa. By the prapta, who is an adhikari? So sambandha is clear there. And prayojana siddhi is also there. Moksha ha. Tat sadhanam brahma jnanam iti arthat siddhyati. So that moksha ha and tat sadhanam brahma jnanam. This is implied there in the sutra. Arthat siddhyati means it is implied. Nothing will be directly said. At sutra level, there is no spoon feeding. Although Vyakhyanas try to do spoon feeding, even there we need more spoon feeding. Otherwise, sutra level, there is no spoon feeding. In fact, in Panini sutras also same thing. All sutras are like that. The sutras are taught and then the rishi will walk away. Then the sampradaya will teach it further by writing more and more commentaries. Then those commentaries will have sub-commentaries, and then still if there are doubts pending, then there will be tippana, and this is how the teaching sampradaya continues. So sutra level, there is no spoon feeding. All this implied meaning has to be known. Vishvato mukham. Sutra is Vishvato mukham. So much meaning is there in athato brahma jidnyasa. These are not, you can't pick up a dictionary, look at four words and make sense. It is not possible. Thereby, mokshecha adhikari visheshanatvena tadvara adhikari visheshani bhutaya moksha tat sadhanam brahma jnanam ityartha siddhyati asti tavad vedanta vakya sanidhyam shravana videhe vidhi samanarthakatvena sutrasya api tat sanidhyam asti ityatah vedanta vakyehi advaita atma vichara siddhyati. So whatever meaning was there in the shravana vidhi, the same meaning is there in the sutra. There were doubts pending. Here, through Nyaya, through Tarka, it will be established. Therefore, there won't be any doubts pending about Shrotavya Vidhi. And then, the Arthavada Vakyas and the Mukhya Tatpariya Vishaya, there won't be any doubts. The Brahma Sutra is going to make everything completely clear and doubtless for the person who is following it. So that is the meaning here. Finally, what? Asti tavad Vedanta Vakke Sanidhyam Shravana Vidhe. Shravana Vidhi has Sanidhyam, is in close proximity to these Tattvamasi Ityadi Mahavakyas. And Vidhi Samanarthakatvena Sutrasya Api Tat Sanidhyam Asti Eva. And by Vidhi being the same, Shrotavya Vidhi and Brahma Jijnyasa Kartavya, both are having the same meaning, Ekartha. And since the Shrotavya Vidhi has Sanidhya Vidhi Tattvamasi Mahavakyas and the Tatpare Vishaya Mahatatpare Vishaya, similarly, the Arthavada Vakyas will give you what? Anubandha Chatushtaya. And through that, Sadhana Chatushtaya. But the main Tatpare, Mukhya Tatpare is Aikya Vishaya. Therefore, this Sutra will also have Anubandha Chatushtaya and the main Tatpare. Why? Because of Ekartha with the Shrotavya Vidhi. Thereby sutrasya tat sanidhyam asti, tat sanidhyam, same sanidhyam, which is that Vedanta Vakya sanidhyam, tat is Vedanta Vakya. Ityataha, therefore what? Vedanta Vakyehi advaita atma vichara siddhyati. Through the sutra it is established. Tathacha sadhana chatushte sampannena adhikarina, moksha sadhana brahma jnana, Vedanta Vakyehi advaita atma vichara kartavyaha, iti sutrasya tatparyena pratipadyortha. So now your meaning has become more enhanced. Earlier, what was it? Tathacha sadhana chatushte sampannena adhikarna brahma jnana vichara kartavyaha. This was the sutra artha. Now this is extended. What is the meaning now? Sadhana chatushte sampannena adhikarna, which was there earlier as well. Sadhana chatushte sampannena adhikarna. What is there? Brahma jnana vichara. Now what is that? Moksha sadhana brahma jnana. Phalibhutam is that. Brahma jnanaya moksha sadhana brahma jnanaya. When we say phalibhuta, then jnana is sadhana. Thereby moksha sadhana brahma jnanaya vedanta vakyehi advaita atma vichara karta. And what vichara should you do? Vichara kartavya. earlier there was no visheshana to vichara. Now it is Vedanta Vakyaihi Eva Advaitatma Vichara. Vichara has visheshana as Advaitatma Vichara, not any other vichara. And how should you do it? Not sitting in a cave by yourself. Vedanta Vakyaihi Eva. You can do it in a cave after Vedanta Vakya Shravana, of course. But then, manana can be done anywhere. I'm just saying that without Upadesha, one should not do it. Iti sutrasya tatparyena, tatparyena pratipadyartha. And there are many people who object to this, you know. How can you tell me what to do? Especially modernists, you know. I am free to do anything. Swatantra Karta has been mentioned by Panini Maharshi long back. But these people have woken up to it now. So these, whatever, you know, we call it woke people or whatever. They'll say, in the sampradaya itself. So they'll say, no, I have got buddhi. I have so many options available. Why should I do vichara with Vedanta Vakya? Why should I, you know, I am qualified enough. I'll study books. Does not work. Just like you cannot become a doctor by studying Harvard medicine books. Nobody will come to you. So there you have different rules. Oh, Harvard University means I need a big fat, fee structure. I need, 99 percentile kind of a student I should be. I need all sorts of entrance exams. Then I'll be qualified. And not in any exam and not any qualification, particular qualification. Visheshani Bhuta. There also it is there, but there we don't see it. If someone says, oh, I have studied, Harvard medicine books, all I have studied. They are Kantastha also. I can quote anything from anywhere. Will we go to such a doctor, especially when having a lot of trouble, yes, and on top of that paying hefty, consultancy? We won't go. But somehow, in this case, we have forgotten all that. You can pick up a book and study. So thereby, what will happen? There will be doubts as to how should I do Atmavichara? I'll do it. And then some other saint comes in. We don't even know what is the qualification of that saint. Just like another, a doctor. Medicine, somebody who looks up Ayurvedic books and gives you medication. There are many people, especially Corona, we have seen Corona times, do this, do that. Does not work. Why does it not work? Because it is not in the books in such a manner. It should be learnt in the Ayurveda Sampradaya also. It is a Vedanga. But some may work. Just because something worked, it has worked by Kakatalya Nyaya. There's no relation between the unqualified doctor giving you advice and it working for you. If you go back and then you say, okay, this is a good doctor, I'll go back to him. He's not a doctor. He's not a qualified doctor. He has studied books and given you some advice without knowing without knowing anything, especially. Actually, nothing. He knows nothing in how the human body works, how this Ayurveda medicines work, then what will happen? There will be side effects. There can be side effects, not by the medication. Taking something which is completely unrelated, the disease is progressing and then you have something else due to the medication. See, they say there is no side effect to Ayurvedic medication. But then there is no side effect to food also. Herbal medication, right? There is no side effect to food. But then one who should not be eating sweets, one who should not be eating spicy, will start eating those. In that case, what will happen? If he were to start eating restricted food, what will happen? Patya is there in Ayurveda also. The person hasn't studied. Therefore, there will be side effects. The same thing happens here also. There is Jnana Bhasa. There are a lot of people who have Jnana Bhasa. And they end up doing anything and everything, hurting the sampradaya, hurting themselves. First of all, hurting themselves because it is very swartha. The pursuit is swartha. One wants moksha for one's own sake. One wants everything for one's own sake. Atmanustu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. Then following something where somebody is not qualified, one will end up taking decisions which will hurt one's own progress towards moksha. So this is something that we need to be alert about. So tathaja sadhana chatushte sampanyena adhikarana moksha sadhana brahma jnana vedanta vakyaihi advaita atma vichara kartavya iti सूत्रस्य तात्पर्येण प्रतिपाद्यो अर्थः. सो दिस इज द फाइनल मीनिंग रिवील्ड बाय द सूत्र. सेम सूत्र ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा कर्तव्य अथात ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा कर्तव्य वेयर देर वॉज नो अन्वय पॉसिबल. नाउ इट इज रिवीलिंग सो मेनी थिंग्स बिकॉज ऑफ लक्षण appropriate lakshana or appropriate units of the word and thereby getting the mimamsa right and getting the complete meaning. Now there is an objection. Nanu vichar lakshanaya eva kartavya padasya anvaya sambhavat apramaniki jnana lakshanaiti chet. Personally I feel there are some typos here, so I am going to interpret the way I understand, otherwise I'll have to skip it. सो ननु विचार लक्षणया एव कर्तव्य पदस्य अन्वय संभवात. देर शुड बी अन्वय संभवात. आई थिंक दिस आकार इज आउट ऑफ प्लेस. ऑफकोर्स आई शुड नॉट करेक्ट इट, सो बिकॉज आई डोंट हैव आई थिंक आई सॉ अनदर बुक बट देन आई डिडंट सी आकार मिसिंग देर. सो लेट सी आई एक्सप्लेन व्हाट आई अंडरस्टैंड. ननु विचार लक्षणया एव कर्तव्य पदस्य अन्वय संभवात, अदरवाइज दिस डाउट कांट बी देर. अप्रामाणिकी ज्ञान लक्षण. सो ज्ञान ऑन दी प्रकृति ज्ञान एंड देयर बाय इच्छा ऑन दी प्रत्यय. यू हैव डन लक्षण इन बोथ केसेस. नाउ व्हाट इज इन विचार लक्षण एव. थ्रू दी विचार लक्षण मीनिंग दी प्रत्यय वेर यू हैव एडेड जी जहल लक्षण और इंटरप्रिटेड बाय जहल लक्षण. Through that lakshana itself, kartavyatva can work. You can say, vicharah kartavya. Although ichha kartavya does not make sense, vichara kartavya anvaya is possible. There is no objection there. Now, lakshana should be added only when the meaning makes no sense. That being the niyama, why do you go overboard and do lakshana on jnana also? Why do you take phalibhuta jnana? Just say brahma jnanaya vichara kartavya. That can be the shrauta artha. Why do you do an additional lakshana? And very smartly, what have you done? You have started with that lakshana. But don't think that I have missed it, says the Purva Pakshi. I know you have added lakshana on jnana before you added lakshana on ichha. But now that I see, if you do lakshana on the ichha, vichara kartavya, then the anvaya is possible. Then gaurava dosha is there. Why do you go overboard and add lakshana on the prakriti also, jnana? So that is the objection there. Therefore, what? Apramaniki jnana lakshana iti chet. No. So the reply is no, there is lakshana needed on the jnana pada also. Why so? Jnana lakshana anangikare. If you do not accept that, jnanasya sukha prapti dukkha nivritti anyatara rupatva bhavena swatav purushartatvaya ayogad. So purushartatva ayogad. So I have some brahma, I have told in the earlier patha also. When the words get split across, the word itself gets split across lines, I have some trouble there. I have some brahma at times. So I may make some mistake. So sukha prapti dukkha nivritti anyatara rupatva abhavena swatav purushartatva ayogad jnanaya vichara kimartha. Kaha artha yasya iti kimartha. What is the meaning? Kimartham can also be there. Kimartham is well known. But then here you see, actually in these books they don't follow this. When a vowel follows, there should be a makara, not an anuswara. And in most of these books you see that mistake. Even in new books you see that mistake. So if you do not do lakshana on jnana, what will happen? Jnana cannot give you phala. What kind of phala can it not give? Jnana sukha prapti. Jnana itself is not. Jnanasya sukha prapti dukkha nivritti anyatara rupatva bhavena. Jnana cannot give you sukha. Jnana cannot give you dukkha nivritti. So you have to take an example of Rajju Sarpa, and you can take the example, the other example of Shukti Rajata also. Shukti, you look at silver, it makes you happy. You look at Sarpa, it gives you Bhaya, it makes you Dukhi. Now, once you know Jnana, you get Jnana. This Jnana itself cannot give you Sukha. If you know there is no, if you have Jnana of Shukti as Shukti, or you know Rajju as Rajju, by itself, directly, of course, in the end, Antato Gatva, it will take away your Dukkha and then there will be Sukha. But then, directly did the Jnana take away your Dukkha or give you Sukha? So, Jnana se Sukha Prapti Dukkha Nivritti Anyatara, either of those. Rupatva Abhavena. Jnana itself, Jnana Swarupa is not Sukha or Dukkha. It may lead indirectly, you will associate finally that you have Sukha or you have Dukkha. So Jnana by itself cannot give you Sukha, it cannot take away Dukkha by itself. Directly it cannot do that. So Jnana se Sukha Prapti Dukkha Nivritti Anyatara Rupatva Bhavena Swatav Purusharthatvaya Purusharthatva Yogad Purusharthatva Yogad. So due to Jnana itself not being Sukha Rupa or Dukkha Rupa, this is how we have to interpret finally. Jnana may lead you to it finally, Kramena, but Jnana by itself is not Sukha Rupa, Dukkha Rupa. Jnana is a different guna in Nyaya also. Jnana, then Sukha Dukkha. Jnana is, there they say Buddhi, which is Jnana. So Buddhi, Sukha Dukkha, Ichha, all these are gunas. Jnana is different from Sukha, Jnana is different from Dukkha. So Swarupa of Jnana is not Dukkha Nivritti and is not Sukha also. But your Moksha is what? Sukha Prapti and Dukkha Nivritti. Dukkha Nivritti and then Sukha Prapti. Thereby, Swataha Jnanasya Purusharthatva Yogad. Jnana by itself cannot be a Purushartha. You cannot say, why am I doing all this? I need Dharma, I need Artha, I need Kama and I need Jnana. That makes no sense. Therefore, Jnanaya Vicharaha Kimarthaha, if you ask, iti Vichara Lakshanaya Appi Aprayojakatvena Anavashyakyatvad Anvayanupapattehe Tadavasthyam Ityashankam Varetum Jnanayapi Lakshanayaha Svikaryatvad. Because Siddhanti says that if I just do Lakshana on Pratyaya, then you may not come up with an objection. Someone else will come up with an objection, which I already know, that Jnana by itself has no Swarup of Sukha Dukkha. Thereby, since Sukha Prapti and Dukkha Nivritti is not the Jnana Swarupa, therefore, if you ask Vicharaha Kimartha, Jnanaya Vichara Kimartha, because with Jnana, what am I going to get? Finally, someone will ask you. You study medicine, you will become very famous, a good quality doctor. If you study well. So you'll get Jnana, you'll get knowledge about medicine. Okay, what will I get? If I have knowledge of medicine, what will I get? One is not happy just by, getting knowledge of medicine. If there are, doubts and you are searching for it, there is Dukkha there that goes by Jnana through Krama. But by itself, nobody is happy being a doctor unless, if somebody wants to serve the community, then there he is happy. Somebody wants to make money by, treating patients or not treating patients, what have you. He is happy there. So, it is a stepping stone. Directly, it is not making a person Sukhi. Jnana is not a Purushartha. Therefore, somebody will raise an objection there. Vichara Kimartha. Why should I do Vicharaha? Iti Vichara Lakshanayaha Api Aprayojakatvena. Even if I do Vichara Lakshana, there is no Prayojana. because still anvaya is not possible, meaning is not possible. Anavashyakatvad kasya vichara lakshanaya, then you will say drop the vichara lakshana also because it makes no sense even after that. Therefore what? Anvaya anupapattehe, anvaya does not make sense and therefore tadavastyam ityashang anvaya, after doing the vichara lakshana also anvaya does not make sense, so the objection would stand the way it stood earlier. Tadavastyam iti ashankam varayatu jnane api lakshanaya svikaryatva, therefore lakshana ajal lakshana on jnana is accepted, is done. Nanu tathapi jnanasya swataha, jahal lakshana, so jnanam ajal phalibhutam jnanam ajal lakshana, so ajal lakshana not giving the meaning of jnana you lead to phalibhuta jnana. So ajal lakshana is accepted in jnana also, meaning in prakriti also. Nanu tathapi jnanasya swatah phalatva yogaha durvara. Now the Purvapakshi is taking cue from the Siddhanti's explanation. He says, this would have been the doubt. No, now this is exactly my doubt. Even after you do that, what is happening? Nanu tathapi jnanasya swatah phalatva yogaha durvara. If that is why you have done the lakshana, now I understand that's a good intention with which you have done lakshana, but that is not resolved. The purpose for which you did lakshana on the second word, meaning the prakriti also, even after that resolution is not complete. Tathapi jnanasya swatah phalatva yogaha durvaraha. By itself, jnana can give you no sukha prapti or it cannot take away dukkha, dukkha nivritti, cannot give you iti akshepe. Sati, what happens? Iti akshepe prapte. Once this akshepa is done, then tadayogam suchayan jnanasya phalatvam sutra tatparyartha katana vyajena vivrunoti. So under the pretext of explaining the sutra, what is it being done? He explains, gives an answer, tatreti. Ratna Prabha, tatra jnanasya svatah phalatva yogat. Jnana definitely cannot give you, by itself it cannot give you phala. Therefore, what svatah phalatva yogat? Pramatrutva kartrutva bhuktrutvatmaka anartha nivartakatvenev phalatvam vaktavyam. Therefore, kramena it will give you sukha prapti, it will give you sukha and it will take away dukkha, it will give you dukkha nivritti. How so? Pramatrutva kartrutva bhuktrutvatmaka anartha nivartakatvenev phalatvam vaktavyam. So, phalibhuta jnana is what kind of jnana? That jnana which is sadhana to moksha, which is sukha prapti dukkha nivritti rupa, but how? By taking away the kartrutva bhoktrutva bhava, that I am a pramata. Why pramata? Because jnana, when jnana is taking place, this person is a pramata. So first that should be dropped and then kartrutva bhoktrutva also has to be dropped. So these are all upalakshana for everything else. What one considers oneself to be other than Sachiranda Atma, all those are to be taken away. And this jnana will take that away. Which jnana? This jnana for Brahma jnana. And thereby, phalibhutam jnanam is what? This phala is definitely sukha prapti and dukkha nivritti, but it is not directly, it is through the jnana taking away your kartrutva bhoktrutva adi misconceptions. Tika sutra jnana padasya lakshanangikare ityartha. So tatra means what? Again, once you accept the lakshana the way it is done in the sutra on both prakriti and pratyaya. Brahma jnanasya ichha vishayatvat purushartha rupa phalatvam pratiyate pratiyamanasya phalatvasya swarupena ayogat phalasadhanatvena eva tat vaktavyam. Tat sadhya phalam kim ityakangshayam atha shabda upatta adhikari visheshani bhuta anartha nivritti rupa moksha phalatvena sambadhyate. So how the prayojana is connected? Brahmajnanasya ichha vishayatvat. Since Brahmajnana is ichha vishaya, why? Because it will give you moksha. How so? It is said Brahmaveda Brahmayo bhavati. You know that Brahmaveda Brahmayo bhavati. Brahma is Ananda Rupa. I want to have that Ananda. It is Nityananda Rupa. So I want that Nityananda. And therefore, Brahma Jnana I need. Am I an Adhikari? Yes. I will inculcate all the qualifications, whatever, all the gunas which are needed in Adhikari, I'll inculcate those and then finally go back. Brahma Jnana Ichha Vishayatva. Brahma Jnanasya Ichha Vishayatva. Since this becomes an Ichha Vishaya now, I want Brahma Jnana. For what purpose? Not for Jnana. Jnana is not my Purushartha. It is a sadhana for moksha. Similarly, Brahma Jnana, who will get it? An Adhikari. Who is an Adhikari? I am not an Adhikari. Then I want to be an Adhikari. Not for the sake of becoming an Adhikari. To become the Sadhaka is not my goal. My goal is still Moksha. For Moksha, I need Jnana. Which Jnana? Brahma Jnana. For Brahma Jnana, I need to have qualification. So for that, I have another target now. So I want to become a Sadhaka Adhikari. For that, what all do I need? So again, you keep on going back and finally start where you find yourself to be having those qualities or whatever is there. Whatever is your end goal, where you are in the journey, you keep on going back and then start from there. Finally, we don't jump, you know, finally we'll reach there, but we don't jump, you know, from the first step to the last. Whichever step you are on, based on your own Purva Samskara, you continue there. Therefore, Brahma Jnanasya Ichha Vishayatvat Purushartha Rupa Phalatvam Pratiyate. Brahma Jnana by itself is not Purushartha, but it appears to be so. Because there is Ichha. Right now at least, I have Ichha in Brahma Jnana. Because that is my immediate goal. Pratiyamanasya Phalatvasya Swarupena Ayoga. But this Phala is not Purushartha really. Even if you want, if someone says, you know, why are you doing this? Oh, I'm a, you know, Jnana Yogi, whatever people call themselves. I, you know, I prefer this Jnana Marga. Why? Oh, I want Brahma Jnana. Then others ask you, why do you want it? So then you know that, oh, Brahma Jnana by itself, I don't want to stop there. I want it not for Brahma Jnana, not for bookish knowledge. I want it for moksha. It should lead me to Sakshatkara. Therefore, Swarupena Ayoga Phalatvasya Pratiyamanasya Phala. It appears to be a Phala, but it is not really a Phala. Brahma Jnana itself is not a Phala. Phala Sadhanatvena Tadvaktavyam. Therefore, this is a Sadhana to the Phala. Finally, it is not Moksha itself. It is, we will say Brahma Jnana itself Moksha is because Brahma Jnana will take away the Ajnana as it rises. Once it becomes Dhrida, it will have taken away. So that itself, finally, we'll say Ajnana is Moksha. Because it is Chidrupa Jnana. First it is Vrityatmaka Jnana. Brahmakara Vritti is called as Jnana. But that is Gauna. Mukhya Prayoga of Jnana is in the Satyam Jnana Manantam Brahma. That Prayoga is there. Here Jnana is Vrityatmaka Jnana. Vrityatmaka Jnana is not Moksha. Moksha, Vrityatmaka Jnana itself will turn out to be Moksha when it takes away the Ajnana completely, and therefore what remains is Chidrupa Jnana. So there is a Bheda there. Jnanena Moksha and Jnanameva Moksha. There is a difference. Jnanena Moksha, there Jnana is Vrittirupa Jnanena Moksha. Whereas Jnanameva Moksha is Swarupa, Chitswarupa Jnanameva Mukti Moksha. That is the difference there. So we should not mix it up because there are many people who say, you know, how do you say jnana, jnanena moksha, jnana itself is moksha. All that is right. We should understand the right meaning of the word. So mimamsa kartavya. Thereby what happens? Phalasadhanatvena tadvaktavyam. That jnana should be understood as phalasadhana. Tatsadhya phalam kim. Then what is the sadhya phala? Iti akamshayam atashabdopatta. Adhikari Visheshani Bhuta Anartha Nivritti Rupa Moksha. Now more Visheshana has come. This Moksha had Visheshana of Adhikari. Which Adhikari? Who had a Visheshana of Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti. Therefore, Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampanna Adhikari Visheshani Bhuta Moksha. And what is that Moksha? Also Anartha Nivritti Rupa Moksha. So moksha is what? In Tarkika's way, it would be what? Atha shabda has given you the adhikari. Therefore, atha shabdopatta adhikari visheshani bhute bhutatve sati anartha nivritti rupatvam mokshaha. That is the moksha. And that is the meaning of jnana as phalibhuta jnana phalatvena sambadhyate. And this is how the sambandha with prayojana is also there of vishaya. Yatha swarga kamo yajeta ityatra adhikari visheshani bhuta swarga phalatvena sambadhyate tadvata. So adhikari and the prayojana has sambandha. Just like swarga kamo yajeta. The mantra is just that. Swarga kamo yajeta. Who is the adhikari? Yasmin swarge kamaha vidyate saha adhikari. Therefore swarga kamo yajeta, what should he do? Vidhi. There is a vidhi, vidhi vakya. Yajeta, he should do yaga. So the adhikari is who? Adhikari visheshani bhuta swarga. The swarga is adhikari visheshani bhuta. Whoever has adhikaritvam in that swarga prapti, who has ichha, he should gather whatever qualifications are needed, whatever samagri is needed, all the sadhanas he should bring together. He is one of them. And then he will qualify that moksha. Because that moksha is revealed as swarga kamo yajeta. So swarga, what does he mean? Swarga kamaha yajeta means what? What is this swarga kamaha shabda? A particular adhikari is there who has kama in swarga. Therefore, adhikari visheshani bhuta swarga phalatvena sambadhyate. Kena sambadhyate? Adhikarina saha tadvata. Similarly here also, this sadhana chatushte sampanna adhikarina saha moksha sambadhyate. Prayojana rupa moksha sambadhyate. So there is a sambandha between adhikari and moksha prayojana also. How do you know this? Athatu brahma jijnyasa, there is atha shabda is there. So atha shabda tells you the adhikari and brahma jijnyasa kartavya, thereby phala you know. By? As phalibhuta jnana. So much meaning is there in the sutra. Ataha phalibhuta moksha sadhanatvena brahma jnanasya phalatvam yujyate iti jnanaya vicharaha yukta iti bhava. Then again, jnanaya vicharaha yukta, vishaya, phala sambandha is there, prayojana sambandha, and then adhikari prayojana sambandha is also there. Hetu ukti dvara anartha nivartakatvam upapadayati. So we'll look at this as to anartha nivartaka. How is this anartha nivartakatvam possible? That we'll look at in the next part. Yamiha karunikam sharanam gatvapyari sahodarapamahatpadam tamaham ashu harim paramashre janakajangamananta sukhakrutim. Any questions? I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Dhanyavaad.
Namaste.